Hey, if you're here, I'm just gonna wait, set up and wait on some of you guys to join in. Hey, Sarah. You can still wave. Are you having a good day? Say hey if you're here, and I'll get started. Hey, Brian. Hey, Robin. Aw. I hate shots. Poor baby. Hey, girl. Okay, I'm gonna start now. Okay, Tiffany. Did you see my blackberry recipe last night? Brian said it's a little too much. Okay, I'm gonna start with telling you guys what I've done so far to my face and my skin. Today was exfoliation day, so I try to exfoliate once or twice a week to really speed cellular turnover. So today I... Oh, you kill Blackberry Sherry. Hey, Alicia. Hey, Tiffany. How about that pumpkin costume? Hey, Casey. Okay, so today's exfoliation day. I always try to exfoliate at least twice a week to get rid of the dead skin cells and just get a glow and speed cellular turnover. So I have exfoliated today with the Polishing Exfoliator. Hey, Alicia. And I forgot my collagen night pack. I forgot to put this on last night. Oh my gosh, I am not beautiful right now. I have no makeup on. I have on lips and eyes, though. Look, y'all, this is from yesterday after scrubbing it off in the shower. This is Kiss for a Cause with Baked Champagne. If I look semi-decent, it's probably because I did spray tan last night. That's what I'm getting to. So the collagen night pack is amazing. If you want more information about that, let me know. It is Botox in a bottle. Hey Kayla, hey Casey. And my tan is brought to you today by our self-tanning bronzing coconut milk. And you guys are probably going to laugh because I do this all the time, but I still get nervous when I go live. I'm like shaking. Okay, so I'm going to get started. I'm going to start with taking off my lips and my eyes. And other than leftover from yesterday, I have nothing on. So you rub the Oops Remover. It does smell like cherries. I love this bronzing coconut milk. This is results after two applications, though. So I put it on Monday night and then didn't exfoliate other than my face. And I did my second coat last night. And this is the result. Hey, Jessica. These are $50. This is our bronzing coconut milk. It also contains our Cineplex Complex, which will make your entire body... speed up cellular renewal. And oh my goodness, I have no baby wipes. How can I do makeup without baby wipes? I'll be right back. I'm gonna go get, shout out to all the mamas on here who have like 500 baby wipes in their house right now. Mine have outgrown baby wipes, but I still buy them to use for myself and apparently I've not restocked. So I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some wet paper towels. And I'm still in my pajamas, by the way. 2 o'clock in the afternoon, winning. I'm gonna be so lost without my baby wipes. Okay, baby wipes are a major key when you're a makeup artist. So let's try out these wet paper towels. So I put the Oops Remover on my lips. So I'm gonna rub back and forth. Hey Tammy, hey Jennifer, hey Caitlin. And I remove, that's how easy it comes off. A lot of people say, oh my gosh, it's long wear makeup, but how does it come off? Will I be able to get it off? Yes, this is not a tattoo. This is makeup, ladies. It will come off. My favorite thing to use is our Oops Remover and our Foops Remover. So I'm just gonna take our Foops Remover, which is like a little oil, kind of like an eye makeup remover, and I'm going to dip Q-tips in it, and I'm just going to take off what's left on my eye from yesterday. If you think our lip sense stays on well, oh my gosh, you've got to try our shadow since I use it for everything. Okay. Now I'm going to start with, I already have on my anti-aging day cream. I use the dry formula because I have dry skin, but we also have oily to acne. Yay, there's 19 people on. Hey Tammy, did I already say that? Jennifer just said peace. Are you already leaving? Okay, I'm gonna start with my foundation. I am obsessed with our foundation. I still try out other foundations just to compare because I wanna always make sure that I'm using the best, not only on myself, but on my clients as a makeup artist. So this week I was testing out the Tarte Amazonian Clay. This is a full coverage foundation. I tested it out. I wore it 2 days in a row on my face, half Synergence, half the Amazonian Clay, and I don't know if you can tell, but this side of my face looks a lot better than this one. That's after only not wearing Synergence foundation for 2 days. I always, every time I test out a new foundation, I always break out too. Our foundation doesn't get oily. It stays all day long. It's amazing. Okay, so I'm going to start with our medium tinted color correcting moisturizer. This is only a moisturizer. It doesn't have an SPF in it. It has an actual mechanical shield that shields your skin from the sun, pollution. So I'm just going to stipple it on. This is called stippling. This is a stipple brush. Stippling means patting in for an airbrush finish. Stippling is amazing. You can even use store-bought foundation to practice with, and you're still going to get a better effect than you would if you used a beauty blender or your fingers, because stippling is the best way to apply. You love the foundation, Robin? Awesome. Yes, I'm almost out. But you guys, look. Oh, no, that's a pearlizer. Yes, medium. Yes, I'm almost out, but look how long this tan foundation lasts me 6 months using on myself and my clients, and I bet I could still get more out. Let's see. Ready? You get every last ounce of this bad boy. That's how much I got from one squirt. So I'm going to stipple that on as well. And I use the shade Tan. Even when I'm not spray tanned or have on our coconut oil, I can still use the same color because ours has scientific technology to where color conforms to your own skin, 3 shades lighter or darker. So there's no need for a winter and a summer foundation unless you go from like Casper to Hawaiian Tropic, but who does that? Yes, I love the air pumps too, Jennifer. Hey, Stacy. So I'm stippling in our foundation. Everything's gone. I'm gonna take the leftover down my neck and my chest because I want the anti-aging and the skin shielding properties to also go to my neck and chest. Your décolleté and your neck actually tend to age faster than your face. Always use skincare on them as well, okay? So now I'm gonna move on to candlelight. If you don't know what candlelight is, then you're not living, okay? This is candlelight. It's our shadow scent. I use it all over my face. This is like my crack. I buy it by the gallon and I use it for everything. I'm going to go in and I'm going to conceal with it. When you conceal, you don't want to go right under your eye. You want to make a V. This is your window of light. I'm going to cover any, you have acne, dark spots, anything. It's going to cover it all. It's also peach toned, so peach cancels out darkness. So it's the perfect color for under your eyes. And if you can tell, I'm just patting this in with my finger. You can use a concealer brush if you'd like. And you can leave it pigmented, more pigmented by patting it in instead of rubbing it back and forth. So this is our candlelight shadow scents. I'd say this is probably one of my must-have products that we sell. One of my all-time favorites. I use it when I first start my makeup and when I'm finished for an instant eye lift. I love our eye illuminator too, but it's a little bit more expensive. And I think that this gives a more dramatic look. I'm an honest salesperson. This is a third of the price. And it makes more of an instant impact, whereas our eye illuminator over time improves your under eye. I'm just simply swiping on some of our bronzing powder to set my foundation. What do y'all want to see me do today? Anyone? Hey, Heather. So that is our color correcting tinted moisturizer. My hair is a hot mess. I've been cleaning and sweating all day. So I am wearing now our color correcting tinted moisturizer, which is amazing. And our Synergence anti-aging foundation with our candlelight and just a barely even a swipe of bronzing powder. Okay, Alicia. Okay, Jennifer says she wants a soft natural look and Alicia says she wants to know how I do my eyes. Okay, I usually do them different every day, but I will go ahead and show you guys a soft light brown everyday look. I'm going to use Mocha Java to start with. This is Mocha Java. Mocha Java is a light brown, taupey color. Hey, Lenora! Okay, Mocha Java is a light brown taupe. This is the perfect brow filler if you have blonde to medium brown hair. I'm going to use it on my eyelid. So I'm just swiping it across. So I just swipe that across, and that's going to make, it's a lot darker on people who aren't as dark. So usually I have to add in Garnet to mine. So that's Mocha Java. And I'm going to go ahead and fill in my brows. For my brows, I have dark hair, so I use Garnet to fill in my brows. I take a brush like this, a brow brush. I just simply put a little bit of the product on the edge, and you're gonna follow your natural brow growth. So you're gonna go up and over. This is the best brow filler I've ever used. It's super user-friendly, very easy. It's waterproof, it doesn't fade. Now you have an eyebrow. You see the difference? What did that take, 5 seconds? I used to have to use about 3 different products to get this type anywhere near that much of an impact. So this is Garnet Shadow Sense that I'm putting on my brow. As I said before, our shadows can be used all over your face. I'm gonna also use that same color and brush and do under my eyes. Hi, Christine. Thanks, Alicia. Yeah, it's super easy. It's probably the easiest brow filler that you can use. It's storming. It's super humid and hot. Okay, so I took the Garnet that I used on my eyebrow, and I just barely even, these are $22 each. They last forever, because when I say a little goes a long way, a little goes a long way, and they also only need to be applied once a day, never touched up. They're waterproof, smudge proof. They're never gonna go under your eye and create a raccoon look. They're never gonna fade. So I'm just taking the Garnet and I'm just using it as a little bit of an accent on the outer corner of my eye. So that's just a soft brown look. You always want to try to go brown over black with a smoky eye, unless it's a nighttime look, because it's a lot less harsh. So that was super easy. Sorry guys, I'm getting like super sweaty and shaky. I've got to prick my finger. Diabetes life. But next I'm going to show you guys my favorite blush that finally came back in stock. It's called Toasted Rose, and show you how easy it is to apply. Sorry. Okay, now let's do blush, and then we'll do lips, and I'll finish up the eye look. So for blush, we're going to go with Toasted Rose today. I love this color. It looks great on everybody. This is also cream to powder and anti-aging, smudge-proof, crease-proof, waterproof. I'm going to go in with my blush brush, and I'm just going to stipple it on. Don't smear. Never smear cream products over your foundation, because it's going to make it... don't rub back and forth. It's going to make it smear, and it's going to smear what you already have on. You don't want to smear your foundation, so I'm just going to simply stipple it in. I love this color. It's so natural. It just gives you a natural flushed look. When you're applying your blush, you don't want to go on the apples of your cheeks. You want to go under for a slimmer look. Our blushes are $25 each. And when I say a little goes a long way, like with the other products, I mean it. So I use a dot for each cheek. It's also waterproof, smudge-proof, has our Cineplex Complex in it, our CineShield, which is our anti-aging and our skin-shielding products that are patented for only on formulas. all of our makeup is also the only makeup brand that's all exclusively made in the United States. It's all pharmaceutical grade. It's all FDA approved. It's vegan. It's has no harsh chemicals. It is gluten-free. It doesn't have any wax or parabens. It doesn't have oil added to our foundation. So that is how natural just a dot of the toasted rose looks. And then I'm just going to go in with a brush and just blend it. Christine, you can go back and watch the beginning of the video, but no, not necessarily. Honestly, sometimes when I'm in a hurry, I just use Neutrogena face wipes. I'm an honest salesperson. I'm going to tell you that you can use other makeup removers. They will work, but definitely you want the Oops remover with the lipstick, and you definitely, if you can afford it, get the Foops remover to remove the eye stuff. The eye stuff that I started with at the beginning of the video is what was left after I used a Neutrogena wipe this morning before I did my exfoliating, a polishing exfoliator. So I had to remove the rest of it with the Foops remover. But if you have something you already use and love, you can definitely try that. But I would highly recommend the Oops remover for the lip stuff, especially if you were to make a mistake. Now I'm going to go in with Bronze Blush Stamps and take just a dot of that, and I'm going to use it to contour. So this is how this little tube lasts a year or two, dependent upon if you use it every day or not, because it only requires a dot. Our makeup has a shelf life of 7 years once opened. So when you contour, you want to go with where your lid ends and not like you're going to touch the top of your ear. I'm also asked a lot about how long one lip sense lasts. One lip sense, ounce to ounce, is equivalent to about 4 tubes of your regular drugstore lipstick. But it's also going to have to be applied only once a day. And it has a shelf life of 7 years. If you use one lip sense every day, the exact same one, 3 coats once a day, it's going to last about 6 to 9 months. Most people don't use only one. They buy multiple and they color combine. So there's endless choices. So I'm going to go in and finish my eye. I'm going to use a drop of snow with a drop of candlelight. If you can see, I like to mix everything. All of our stuff mixes very well. It's all cream to powder, other than the bronzing powder I applied. So I just took a dot of the candlelight and a dot of the snow. A great color to use instead of this would be our Sandstone Pearl Shadow Tints, but it's out of stock right now. And the ones that I had, I sold to clients. So I'm just going to mix this on this top. I'm going to take it under my eye. In the inner corner of my eye. Christine, no, this makeup does not run. If you want to go look through my YouTube videos, Christine, my YouTube is Kisses and Glam. There is a video where I dunk my entire head in a bowl of water and then try to remove my makeup with a white towel, and it does not come off. Once it's set, so see what I'm doing right now is the shadow sense, and I'm applying, this is your window corner. This is where you want your highlight with your shadow. So I'm just putting it right here and then under my brows. And if this is too bright for you, you could use just simply the candlelight, but the candlelight isn't light enough for me for my personal preference. So you see how fast these products are to work with. You can even take, say you love your Naked palette. All of this sets in 60 to 90 seconds, so you have to work with it quickly. And then once it's set, it turns to powder and it's set for the day. I'm going to take my Naked palette and I'm going to go with Snake Bite over my Mocha Java. And that Mocha Java is going to hold this Naked color Snake Bite on like the best shadow primer ever. No, Christine, it doesn't. So at first I was really worried as to what type of chemicals are in them because I like to know what I put in my body and on my skin. And I did a lot of research and I was just blown away at the quality of the things that they use in their products and how they're FDA approved and they have to be up to a certain standard and the pharmaceutical grade. Yes, Jennifer was originally, Jennifer is on my team now, but she was originally one of my customers and she just could not believe, she started with the Shadow Sense and she was just blown away. She wanted every color. She does hardcore workouts every day and just sweats, you know, head to toe. Hey, Christy. Hey, Becky. And she just could not believe that the Shadow Sense did not come off. So she started using all over her face, started with the foundation, bought her first lip color, and she was sold. She wanted it delivered by the truckload. So that's how easy that is to do. So yes, if you still have favorite shadows you can wear, you want to use, you can still wear them. I'm not guaranteeing you that they are going to be waterproof or sweatproof, however, but I'm telling you that using our colors under it will grab it and hold it on like the best shadow primer you've ever used. This is Booty Call. I don't know why these are called names like that. On the Naked 2 palette. And I'm just putting it on the inner corner of my eye. Now I'm going to show you how amazing our Onyx Shadow Sense is. Black liner. Yes, you do, Jennifer. Black liner tends to make people look harsher, but it can also make your eyes crazy pop. So my favorite solution is I wipe everything off the brush. It takes a tiny amount. And then I open my eyelid. I'm even wearing contacts doing this. Usually it would cloud my contacts or irritate my eyes, but ours does not. So I open my eye and I'm just going back and forth. Look at that eye pop. And it looks natural. And this is with Onyx Shadow Sense. So if you're going to use black on your eye and it's not Halloween or you're not going out at night and want a really dramatic look, you want to use Onyx Shadow Sense and you want to put it inside of your eye. It just makes your eye crazy pop and it stays all day. It doesn't run. Trust me, I've tested this makeup out with plenty of cries. It does not budge. I love it. I'm going to show you how to use this as eyeliner. I'm going to take the brush similar that I used on my brows. Actually, I'm going to use a smaller one. Okay, so I'm going to use one a little bit smaller than that. If you've bought my brush sets, I sell my brush sets for $25 for an entire 8-piece. That's like $3 a set. You would be using this one for your liner. So I'm going to take this. I'm only using what's on the end of it. And I'm going to close my eye and pull it taut. And I'm just going to simply go across. You don't want to take your eyeliner all the way to the side. That's going to close your eye up. We want to open our eye up. You want to get as close to the lash line as possible and go to the side. Christine, yes, it can. I've not applied my pearlizer. I'm a little bit crazy about my JLo Glow Pearlizer, and I put it on last when most people put it on with their foundation, but I want every ounce of that bad boy to show. I want to be shimmering like a Krispy Kreme donut. That's the last thing I apply, so I'm just using the Onyx Shadow Sense as eyeliner, and I'm just connecting it at the V. So it's so much more natural than any stick or even gel or waterproof liquid eyeliner I've ever used. Hey, Leanne. Okay, so now I'm just gonna take the Onyx and I'm gonna do so that that is the Onyx Shutter Sense used as liner. If you want even more of a natural look, don't do it across the top of your eyes. Only do it on the inside of your eye and your waterline. Erin, we need to try Ivory on you instead of, we need to try Ivory on you instead of the porcelain. Now I'm going to take our pearlizer. It dried up. Our pearlizer is what I call my J.Lo Glow. I'm obsessed with it. And I'm just stippling that on as well. This also contains our Cineplex Complex, our CineShield. So all of our anti-aging and skin shielding properties. So I'm wearing everything on my face contains CineShield and Cineplex. It changes your skin. It doesn't cover up. Well, it does. It doesn't only cover up though. It makes your entire skin change permanently. I'm sorry, Erin. We could also add in a drop of white concealer. Didn't you already buy the white concealer? You can add in a drop of the white concealer with the foundations to make them a shade lighter, to color correct and have foundation in one with it being a lighter shade than the ivory that you need. Christine, you buy everything separate, but it's still the same price. And usually if you're a first-time client or you're wanting a lot of stuff, you want to get started with all new makeup, I will hook you up. I will take care of you. Just message me. So that's pretty much all of that. Is there anything else you guys want to see? I'm going to go in and contour a little bit more. I already have the bronze blush tints on as contour, and then when I use my powder over it, it will be even more defined. I really like a chiseled face look. If you're more natural, you would just stick to the bronze blush tints. Christine, they do not make, yeah, thank you, Erin. Hey, Maddie, they don't make testers. They used to make, actually, testers for foundation samples. But they don't make any testers anymore. What they do is they offer a 100% money-back guarantee. Like went dark on me. So yes, if you hate it, you don't like it, whatever. No questions asked, you return it. So now I'm going to go in and I'm going to contour a little bit more. I'm actually going to go use the e.l.f. contouring brush. Like $6. Christine, oh my gosh, Asian eyes can be so gorgeous. And yes, on your eyes, you would do exactly what I just did, but you would only line the inside of your eye because we're going to want to make your eye bigger. You're not going to want to do any liner on the top. That's going to close your eye up. We don't want to do that. Another major key for if you have deep set eyes or you're Asian or anything like that is to extend your brow out like I did. You don't want your brow to stop where your eye stops, see? You want to extend it with just a little bit of a wing, just barely. And then you can take your shadow all the way out to where your brow ends. That's going to make your eyes look bigger. So now I'm going to go in with Sonia Kushok. This is the color Goddess. It's a luminosity bronzer. And I'm going to go over my bronze blush tints. So I'm going to do kissy face. I like a really chiseled look. So now I'm going to go around the frame of my face. Both sides of my eye. Down my nose for a slimmer nose look. And under my jaw. You can even do your shoulders, your décolleté, Contouring, basically, you want the contour to be anywhere that natural shadow is, which would be everywhere that I just applied it. This is also a pretty color to take over your shadow and give more of just a bronzy look. And as I said before, that shadow sense is just going to grab that on and keep it all day. I'm going to go back with my big fluff brush and just blend. I have nothing on this brush. I'm just blending. I have on no mascara right now. The only thing I've used so far on my lashes today is our lash extend. Our lash extend is basically no harsh chemical Latisse. Latisse I used for a few weeks and I have some eye issues, so I had to stop using it because it was making pressurization issues in my eye, and that was very alarming to me. I don't want something to make me look beautiful that's gonna harm me internally, so I threw that away. I use our, we have clear, black, and brown lash extend. I don't really have a color preference. I use the clear. I'm going to go on with our black Lash Sense waterproof mascara. This is also swim proof. It also has special moisturizers in it that are going to nourish your lashes and make them longer and stronger with less breakage. It's $20. You notice when I did my lashes on the bottom, I went both sides. Your lashes have two sides. This mascara is very pigmented. I don't even have to re-dip it. I only use what comes out on the swiper. What do you want to call it? Also, I see a lot of you ladies doing this to your mascara. Jamming it in there, pumping it. Don't do that. That puts bacteria into your mascara. Then you're putting that mascara onto your eyes. You're putting bacteria on your eyes. If you are down to the last bit of it, don't pump it. Spin it. Okay, now to the fun part, the lips. And I'll show you guys what I always do last with the candlelight. I always do, I call it my mini eye lift. I always do it last, but first I want to let my mascara dry, so let's do our lips while that dries. What color do you guys want to see today? What color lip? Let's see. Let's do a color that's in stock so you guys can see it. Let's do a color combination. There's Precious Topaz, Praline Rose, Love It, Caramel Apple, Fire and Ice, whatever makes me feel fab. Girl, all of these do. I'm obsessed with our lip senses. If they ever stop making these, I don't even know. Okay. Let's go in with, I'm going to do Praline Rose and Love It. I love Praline Rose. Praline Rose is one of my favorites to layer with. It's a matte. It's in stock right now. The matte lip senses are going to hold on the shimmer, the glitter, and the sheen lip senses. Christy, I don't have Kiss for a Cause, but I have one that I have almost the exact same color and wrapped. It's called Raspberry, which I think Kiss for a Cause basically is its twin. You want me to use that? You want me to show you what Kiss for a Cause would look like? Alicia, yes, I do use Lip Volumizer. I was using it religiously, and I noticed a huge difference, not only in the moisture of my lips, but the plump. I love this stuff. I'm glad you said that, because I have not put it on in over a week. But when I was wearing it religiously every day, I noticed a huge difference in my lips. And also, I noticed a huge difference in my lip sense staying on longer. I guess because my lips were healthier from how much moisture it provides. Okay, Christy. Okay, Kiss for a Cause. Okay. You're gonna go left or right. The thinner the coat, so you see when I took it out, I wiped it all off. The thinner the coat. The thinner the coats. And the longer you wait to dry between coats, the longer it's gonna last. Like nail polishes to your nail, lip senses to your lips. What happens when you put on a big, thick, honking coat of nail polish? It doesn't want to dry. It wants to crack. Similar. This is not a lip stain. This is not a lipstick. This molecularly bonds to your lips. Once it's set, it does not come off. That's one coat of Kissfer Causes Twin Raspberry. And Kissfer Causes in stock. Thanks, I love pinks. Kissfer Causes in stock, and a portion of all proceeds of it go directly to breast cancer research. That's just amazing. I love how our company donates to good causes. All of our makeup, all of the sales of our makeup, they donate a portion to battered women and children. So every purchase you make, is a portion of the proceeds are going to battered women and children. I just love our CEO and our founder. She is amazing. She always stands up for what's right. When we went through the out of stock crisis, which is slowly but surely being fixed right now, praise Jesus. The reason why it took so long is because she wanted to take over her own manufacturing. She wanted to know what went into our products. She wanted to be in control. She wanted to be top notch, the best of the best. Not only that, but she didn't want to outsource to China. We could have had this stuff back in January. She didn't want to build a factory in China or Mexico and make them do our work. She wanted to keep it in America. She wanted to keep it American made. This makeup is one of the only ones that's only solely produced in America. It all has patents on it. No other makeup has our patents. No other makeup, no matter their claim, can do what our makeup does. Not only is it only made in the United States, it's not, it's vegan, non-animal tested, all of it is waterproof, anti-aging, shields your skin from the environment. There's no SPF in our products. It's an actual mechanical shield on your face that is shielding you from the sun, from pollution, from chemicals, everything. There is no other makeup on the market that does this. It's even in our eyeshadow, in our blush, it's in everything. It's amazing. The more layers of it you wear, the more protection you get. Okay, so I'm going to do, so what you want to do is you want to shake it, then you're going to open it. This is how it lasts so long, just like all our products. I feel like I said that about everything I opened. You want to take off all the excess. You're going to keep your lips taut. You don't want, hey Jamie, you don't want any lines, so you keep them taut. You go left or right. Then the top. I'm not doing two coats. I'm doing the inside and the outside. Don't forget your waterline, just like any normal lipstick. Ours will fade at the waterline first because it's being hit with saliva. So that is two coats of Kissfer Causes, and I'm going to go over that with the color Love It. Three lip colors can be combined to make 27. Two lip colors can be combined to make 14. So this would be Kissfer Causes and Love It. Both are in stock. Love It's a pretty peachy pink neutral. So that's those two together. You can even do up to a fourth coat. Gotta make sure they're very, very thin. You do four thin coats, you can create even more than 27 color combinations with three lip senses. And let that dry really good. So that would be two coats of Kissfer Causes, which proceeds, a portion of proceeds automatically go to breast cancer, and then two coats of Love It. Those are also beautiful colors to use on their own. Bethany, I believe the lip volumizer is $50. Mine I used Let me see. I know I used it 6 weeks straight without stopping, and I haven't used it in about a week. And then before that, I used it for, I think, about a solid 8 weeks straight. I just honestly forget about it. Isn't that terrible? I believe it's $50, but it lasts a long while, and you just need a thin coat. I like to put it on before I go to bed and just let it set. And it's a really amazing product, especially for white girls who don't have lips like me. I draw mine on with my lip sense, but you can't tell because it doesn't fade past the lip line. Oh, I used to have to draw them on, but now I don't have to as much because of the lip volumizer. So you other white girls who have no lips, lip volumizer is your friend. You love the lip volumizer, Alicia? Yes, it's amazing. Now I'm going to go in with my MAC gloss. And the gloss, you don't have to do in any certain type of direction. I just go back and forth. You want to make sure you coat it really good, though. That's going to set it. It's also going to protect it. You notice a difference after 2 days? That's awesome, Alicia. Yeah, I've heard, like, I hear everybody ranting and raving over our foundation, the shadow and the lip, of course, the lip volumizer, and our climate control and our collagen night pack. Okay, so that is my look. Do you guys have any more questions before I go? If you have any questions, message me or comment below this live video. I will put this live video on my page. Oh wait, I forgot to do my instant eye lift with the candlelight. Oh my goodness. This is the holy grail. Candlelight is my favorite. Okay, watch. You're gonna go up and over, okay? Now I'm gonna pat it in with my ring finger. Your ring finger is the most gentle. It's not gonna tug and pull on your eyelid, which will create lines and wrinkles. I almost forgot, bless my heart. Hush it, Brian. Yes, it's terrible. It would be terrible. Can you guys see the difference? Of which eye has the candlelight and not? It's insanity. If you wear no makeup, please get you some candlelight and fill in your eyebrows. Also with Mocha Java or Garnet. It's an instant eye lift. This stuff is just amazing. For crying out loud, if you don't wear makeup, it takes literally 5 seconds to put some candlelight under your mama eyes. 30 seconds to put on some lip scents, and about 5 seconds to do your brows, please. Now I'm just gonna go back with nothing on this brush and blend it out. And there is my instant eye lift with the candlelight. So if you want any of these products, comment below this video, post it on my page, or message me, and I will get back to you. Also offering free prizes for certain purchase amounts as well as brush sets. Have a blessed day.